Hello everyone, welcome to the sixth week of our Pacific Music Works online season. This week we are presenting our concert of American music called An American Tune from the concert on March 21st, 2015 at Nordstrom Recital Hall. Ever since I arrived back in Seattle in 2006 from Germany, where I had spent most of the previous 30 years, I've had the feeling that I wanted to reconnect with the music of my own country. It seemed odd that I had spent my formative years in Seattle dreaming of the riches of European music of the past, then a 30-year career in Europe pursuing an ideal of reviving that music in our own time, while largely taking the music of the New World for granted. It became increasingly clear to me that the mind and skill set of musicians in the early music movement, developed as they were to cope with filling in the blanks where the notational records were incomplete and the oral traditions broken or hopelessly confused, were the very ones that had a chance of penetrating the original spirit and sound of the vast panorama of lost American music. I found that many of my closest musical colleagues had a similar feeling, and that some of them possessed a second track in their musical lives which could be directly applied. My old lute duet partner from my first life in Seattle, Tom Berghan, had spent many years researching and practicing a wide variety of old and new music and styles on that most American of all instruments, the banjo. Soprano Cassie Webster, known for her expertise in Baroque music, had been brought up in a musical household devoted to American country music, and her sister is an outstanding exponent of modern country singing. Brandon Vance, known to me as a Baroque violinist, was brought up in the American Celtic tradition and is a champion Scottish fiddler. Tekla Cunningham, our Pacific Music Works orchestra director and Baroque violin soloist, has a double musical heritage from her German mother and her small pipe-playing Scottish father. John Reischman, one of the premier mandolinists of his generation, has devoted his career to bluegrass, newgrass, and old-time music, and is well known as the leader of his own group, the Jaybirds. We begin with the figure of Stephen Foster, arguably the father of American song. Stephen Foster's personal ancestry, Irish and English, may have played a role in the kind of composer he became. Certainly, he had a native gift for melody, and the memorable lilt of his best tunes share something essential with Scottish and Irish folk tunes that had been the mainstay of British parlor music since the 18th century. In the second set of songs, we venture into the Civil War era by following that most iconic figure of the age, Abraham Lincoln. Lincoln was very fond of music and once told a friend, "All other pleasures have a utility, but music is simply a pleasure and nothing more." And I fancy that the Creator, after providing all the mechanism for carrying on the world, made music as a simple, unalloyed pleasure. I look forward to sharing more music with you as part of our 2020 virtual concert season, and encourage you to subscribe to our YouTube channel using the button below. Thank you.
Many days you have been gone. Thank you. love.